Colin Burke, Fossil Labs report number 359.
How did Dr. Robert not predict this? He should have known.
Bobs would eventually gain sentience. Now they've escaped
labs and began living across Barnardshire, with no knowledge of what they're supposed to be. They were made
for surgery. They were made to let anyone become a surgeon. But I'll be damned if my son doesn't deserve a better future than that of a baker. Colin Burke,
Fossil Labs report number 387.
We still have a couple of bobs down in labs, and the most peculiar thing happened. One of the blood vials seemed to almost come alive when a bob was near.
After a few more tests, it would seem
Dr. Roberts' new blood formula
might be the reason for their rise in intelligence.
Incredibly short
sighted, but if I could get some of Bob's blood within
range of a bob, his reaction would be a dead giveaway. My son might still get the chance to practice surgery. Report number 453. The answer was right in front of me this whole time. I took some of Bob's blood and added it to a batch of bread at my bakery. As predicted, when brought near a Bob, it practically came alive. If I could get this bread into the hands of any Bobs in Barnardshire, it'll tell me for sure that they're the Bobs made for surgery. I can track them all down. Now, the technique is not perfect. A loaf of bread seemed to have its animalistic tendencies persist even after no bobs were around. So I'm Colin Burke, Fossil Labs report number 453. The answer was right in front of me this whole time. I took some of Bob's blood and added it to a batch of bread at my bakery. As predicted, when brought near a bob, it practically came alive. If I could get this bread into the hands of any bobs in Barnardshire, it'll tell me for sure that they're the bobs made for surgery. I can track them all down. Now, the technique is not perfect. A loaf of bread seemed to have its animalistic tendencies.